I told you, there's a drug out there that is consumed by more than any person in this entire country. It's not cigarettes and it's not tobacco. It's actually caffeine. It's something that over 90% of Americans drink on a daily basis. And it is something that you don't hear much about because it's not as serious as alcohol or as threatening as tobacco. But it's still something that affects over 90% of people in America. And what a lot of people don't realize is that they actually need this to function. And that's why it's like a drug, is because people get addicted to it. Once you are addicted to it, or once you do it, have it every day, which, as I said, over 90% of people do take it every day, but you also start to develop withdrawals once you don't have it for a while. So what I want to do in the speech is kind of give you an overview of caffeine and tell you some of the things that you might not hear about on TV or in the news, because as I said, it's not as serious, but there are problems and there are better solutions than caffeine like we have every day. So as I said, 90% of people drink caffeine, which is either pop, tea, coffee, at least once a day, 90% of people. And what caffeine is, what caffeine does is it's quickly absorbed from our stomachs into our bloodstreams and travels straight to our brain. It speeds up our heartbeat, and it's broken down into compounds that can affect various organs. And caffeine, they say our body needs so much water every day, and without water, we couldn't survive. Well, caffeine is the opposite of that. Caffeine actually makes us more dehydrated, and it makes us want water more and crave sugary, you know, beverages or foods a lot more than that. And it's actually found in 60 different plants. One of those plants are cocoa beans and the coca plant, and another are tea leaves. So those are, you know, three major things for a lot of our beverages that we get in restaurants or, you know, that we buy at the store. And according to healthambition.com, experts said that drinking 400 to 600 milligrams of coffee a day or caffeine could cause side effects. Some of those side effects include difficulty concentrating, insomnia, muscle tremors, stomach pains, and it also really speeds up your heart rate. This is why it's, like I said, it's not going to really affect you or harm you right away, but over time, it's going to hurt more and more, and it just affects your body. It does nothing good for you. There's no health benefits to caffeine. It also leads to sugary drinks, which is a major product, especially in this country. But, you know, like I said, we have people who drink at least, you know, 400 to 600 milligrams, which is, you know, dangerous. That's these are a couple things that have, and how much caffeine they have in them. An espresso has 240 to 720 milligrams. A cup of coffee, these are all 8-ounce servings, by the way. A cup of coffee is 102 to 200 milligrams. Energy drinks have 50 to 160 milligrams. Root tea has 40 to 120 milligrams. And pop has 20 to 50 milligrams. So, as you can see, if it's dangerous for us to drink 400 to 600 milligrams a day, one cup of coffee is 100 to 200. So four cups of coffee is already at our limit, where it's already dangerous. And that's the thing, is people don't drink just one cup or one pop or one cup of tea. It's multiple all throughout the day. They have to have this, just like any other drug, just like tobacco, you know, just like anything that people are getting addicted to. And one of the things they say, one of the myths, is that coffee, you know, people want to drink coffee because they say, like, I have nothing without my coffee. I need coffee to get going in the day. But really, the thing is that coffee does it. It may help you, give you that jolt because it's increasing your heart rate. But what it's really doing is it's hurting your body, because you want to stay, you can't stay tense all the time. And that's what coffee, you know, it will do, is because the more you drink it, the more your heartbeat speeds up, and then you're unable to relax. So what's going to happen is you're going to drink more, your heart rate's going to go faster, and you're never going to be able to relax. You're going to be literally tense for the entire time. And I talked a little about, you know, being addicted, and just like any kind of addiction, caffeine, you get withdrawals. It takes 12 to 24 hours until you start to feel these withdrawals. And these withdrawals are, I mean, they can last up to a week, it's been reported. And this is from healthandmedical.com. It says the withdrawals include irritability, headaches, stomach pains, and just it causes you to just not feel yourself, and you need, you know, as I said, it feels like you're just missing something. You can't get the urge, you're lazy or lethargic, you feel like you have no energy, which it shouldn't be like that. Your body produces, you know, different things to make, give you that energy, and just drinking coffee shouldn't substitute that. We can do that on our own. And the caffeine has actually gotten so extreme that there are four countries that have actually made it where you can't buy caffeine unless you're 21 or 18 in whatever country. And the four countries are, it's France, Denmark, Uruguay, and Norway. And in all four of these countries, you have to be at least 21 or 18 to buy anything with caffeine, specifically energy drinks. But it's a major problem there. And Uruguay has actually made energy drinks completely legal. You can't buy an energy drink in Uruguay. And that's the point I'm really trying to make, is it's more extreme than people think. Like I said, you're not going to feel these effects right away. But there have also even been accounts of children overdose. There's a 15-year-old in Ohio who had two energy drinks, which was, it's obviously more than he should have had. He shouldn't have even had one. But he had two energy drinks after school and ended up passing away because his heart sped up so fast and his body couldn't handle it. And it actually caused him to pass away. And like I said, this is a rare occurrence, but it is something that can happen. And that's why I think that instead of drinking anything with caffeine, you should try to get yourself just on water in general. That seems to be the most healthy thing, and it's the best thing for our bodies. So water, you know, juice, things like that would be the best thing. But I just wanted to kind of point out that caffeine, while we all drink it, we all drink pop, coffee or tea, whatever it may be, we may all drink it, but it's actually not as healthy or beneficial as we may think. Yeah, you may get that burst of energy, but is it really worth having these kind of side effects or what it's really doing to your body in the long run? So just think about that next time that you reach for that pop or you start to brew that first cup of coffee in the morning, that there's better alternatives and it's really not worth it.